and welcome to Live with Chris, an interview podcast brought to you by Howard Community College, where we can learn and grow together. I am your host, Chris Oviedo, and I want to thank you for joining me today. Howard Community College is excited to invite you and 100 or 200, 500 even, of your best and closest friends and family to our inaugural Fall for All Festival. It's going to be a fun day filled with fall festivities for all ages. And we're going to talk about all of the different opportunities and surprises planned for October 20th right here at HCC with Grace Anastasiadis. She is the Director of Public Relations here at Howard Community College, and she's joining us this morning. Welcome to Live with Chris, Grace.
Hi, Chris. Thank you so much for having me. I really appreciate it.
Absolutely. It is a pleasure to have you. We work together. We see each other in person, but I think this is the first time that I have you on our Vimeo, studio. So this is the first time I see you in the setup. So thanks for being with me.
Yeah, I believe the last time. I think the last time was when Janelle and I did the Women in Theater Conference, which was, I think, during the pandemic. So it's been a while.
Yes. We didn't have the Vimeo studio yet. We were still doing things through Zoom. We were still adapting and adjusting. And that's one beautiful thing about HCC, that we're always adjusting, we're always adapting, and we're always improving, right? So that's exactly what has happened with Live with Chris. We continue to improve. We're now on Vimeo. We can be back in studio. We're working towards that. So just, it really mimics what HCC does and what HCC continues to do. They continue to improve. And in this idea of improvement and inclusion and just creating bigger, better opportunities is where this Fall for All Festival really comes in. And Grace, tell us a little more about this opportunity. What is the Fall for All Festival?
Yes, thank you, Chris. So Fall for All is Friday, October 20th from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. on the Howard Community College campus. And it will be on the quad, and there will be fall festivities for people of all ages. With Howard County Public School systems closed, we wanted to give families, parents, children of all ages the opportunity to come on campus and have a fun day and not stress about getting a sitter or having to find activities for their kids. They can just come here. And we're going to have all kinds of activities for them, including some food trucks so they don't have to worry about packing lunches. HCC has a Sustainability Day every year, so we are joining with Sustainability Day. So it's going to be a 2-in-1, and it's going to be a lot of fun.
It sounds like a really great event, and I love that it's for everyone, right? And I really want us to take a closer look at that name, because I know that that's a very strong mission that HCC has right now. It's the Fall for All, right? So we look at just that word, all. Who is all?
Yeah, that's a great question. All is literally everyone. So it's not only our students or our employees, it's community members. And if you're looking at community members, it's community members, as I said before, of all ages. It can be your 5-year-old or your 85-year-old. So we're planning it with everybody in mind in terms of the activities, whether that's corn mazes. We have corn mazes for the little ones and corn mazes for the maybe slightly taller ones. So the committee is being really thoughtful and trying to ensure that there is something there for everyone. There's going to be corn mazes. Like I said, there's going to be pumpkin bowling. There's going to be food trucks. There's going to be a sack race. There's going to be a cornhole. There's going to be inflatables and bouncy houses, apple tic-tac-toe. There's going to be pumpkin bowling. There's going to be pumpkin decorating, of course, a selfie station. And there's going to be a lot of community involvement. So we've reached out to a lot of community groups within Howard County, like our friends at the Columbia Association, like our fire department friends, and other groups, and they're bringing all of their activities here so we can have a for real community event with the community, involving the community, not just as participants, but also as people who are giving to the community. And that way, not only are people having fun, but they can also find out maybe some fun things about the fire truck that we have coming, or, you know, or our friends, like I said, at HopeWorks or the CA, and really engage with our community partners and our community friends.
I really like that. And, you know, this idea of for all, me being a Latina and knowing that that's, you know, part of who I am, like, this is for my community as well, right? Like Grace just said, it doesn't matter your age, it doesn't matter your race, it doesn't matter your faith, your creed, your sexuality, like, it's for all, it's for everyone. HCC is an open community. It's opening its doors and it wants to invite everyone. I always say, if you're looking for something beautiful to do, just a beautiful place to go walk out, just come to campus. Like, it's really just that pretty. You don't have to come because you're ready to take classes. You just have to come and be, you know, we have this beautiful building here in the middle of Colombia. Just come and interact with it. There's gallery arts that are open right now. We're still in Hispanic Heritage Month, so you can come and there's still Hispanic Heritage art at the galleries, but there's different topics, there's different themes throughout the entire year. So if you're looking for something to do on a free day, come to our campus, right? This is an opportunity where we have an event for the entire family. And I love that HCC is taking this new approach of saying, college is not just for those who graduate high school. College is for all. And we really do that here at HCC. In the summertime, we have programs for the kids. If you are somebody who's retiring, there's a lot of good classes that you can come and take. You don't have to come and get a degree. You can just come and learn photography if that's something that you're passionate about, or baking if that's something that you're passionate about. But you can really come and explore your passions here at HCC. And that's what this Fall for All Festival is. I know I kind of gave it away a little bit, but I want to hear, Grace, you know, because I know you also feel strongly, and I know that you're also well connected with many different communities outside of HCC, right? This idea of for all, help us expand a little bit more on that.
Yeah. So I want to go back a little bit and talk about the inception of this Fall for All. So our wonderful new president, Dr. Daria Willis, saw that there was a need in the community for some sort of, we wanted to have it around Halloween, but not really have it be Halloween. So of course, people could show up in their Halloween costumes or attire if they wish to, but that's not really all inclusive, right? Because not everybody celebrates Halloween, but everybody does eat candy and everybody loves a good time. And so she tasked us with this beautiful festival, which is what it's grown into, and really taking into consideration the community needs, which is why we made it during the day where HCPSS schools are closed, and really to be that fallback in the community to have them say, just like you said, come to our beautiful campus, come to the event is going to be in the quad, come to our quad and really look at the leaves change and have some candy and have some music and see some friends and some community partners. And of course, there is a rain location in the Horowitz Performing Arts Center. That's why we thought about food as well, because we want people to come and we want them to stay and to mingle with us and to play those games and to have a great time. And like I said, Sustainability Day is also going to be here at the SET building, at the SET building, which is not far from the quad. So there's going to be literally stations there for everybody to do some sort of activity, whether they want to get their face painted or they would like a caricature artist to draw them, or whether they would like to just mingle and walk around or grab a pumpkin or grab a piece of candy. So that's something that we really have thought diligently about with the committee, to make sure that there is something there for everyone.
So it's really a festival for all, and you can just come as you are. I love that idea. If you celebrate Halloween and you want to dress up, that's a good idea to do it. If you are somebody who loves, I know that we have like the Renaissance Festival, and we have, you know, the fall there's so many fall activities and in October and all of this nice dress up ways that you can just celebrate yourself. It's sweater weather. So maybe you just come with a nice big sweater. I mean, however you come, however you're comfortable, come as you are. That's the message of the Fall for All Festival here at HCC. You've mentioned pumpkin bowling. Was that, can you tell us more about that? I am so curious. What does that look like?
Yes, of course. So we have many different subcommittees inside the committee. So there's a vendor subcommittee and there's a community subcommittee, and all of these station subcommittee, they've worked really, really hard to try to find activities for all. And so pumpkin bowling was born. And it's going to have pins, and you're going to get a pumpkin, and you're going to try to roll the pumpkin through the pins and see if you can win some candy or a little prize. So there's a lot of wonderful creative people here. And so they've really put their creativity and love for the community into trying to get something that would really be fun and people would appreciate and also have a good time.
So how do people prepare, right? I know we mentioned food trucks. I know we mentioned different stations. I know we mentioned a lot of fun. So how do people prepare to come and have a good time here at Fall for All? What do they need to bring with them?
Yeah. So it is a free event. So you don't need to bring any sort of money. I would say dress comfortably and in layers, because as we know, in Maryland, the weather is one way and then it is not one way. So make sure you're comfortable, because it is going to be outside and there might be some walking. But also, if you would like to partake of the food trucks, make sure you bring some money with you so you can have that experience. And there's going to be several food trucks, so you're not only limited to one option or two options. And we are encouraging everybody to come in and park in Lot A, which is to the left of the circle, which is right at the beginning of campus, and then just walk to the quad, which is where all the majority of the festivities are going to be. We'll have a little row of festivities going into the set building where sustainability is going to be, and there's going to be decoration of pots and all kinds of green things over there. Bob Marietta has done an immaculate job once again, making sure that all of our community partners are here and represented. And so it's going to be popping.
Do people need to register ahead of time and to be able to attend the festival? Oh, I see your head shaking already.
No, just like you said, come as you are.
Come as you are. And let's remind everyone what happens if it rains, because I know that when it rains, we usually are like, oh, is it still going to happen? So I know you kind of gave us a little bit of a glimpse of what's going to happen then.
Yes, we're going to move everything into the Horowitz Visual and Performing Arts Center. So, of course, if it rains, we're probably not going to have the bouncy houses in the Horowitz Center. But we could have events like the pumpkin bowling that we discussed, which is totally inside safe. So, and some corn mazes for the little ones, hay mazes and things like that. So we would definitely adjust, but we're hoping for no rain. We're doing the no rain dance, so there's no rain.
So if you're at home watching, go ahead and dance with us. Yes. So we have no rain. So we have a beautiful, sunny fall day for all here at HCC on October 20th. Let's all bring good energy to that day. Grace, where can people find all this information? Where can they go? And where can they also find more information about everything else that's happening here at HCC?
Sure. So for the Fall for All event, we have a dedicated site on our website. It's howardcc.edu/fallforall. So you can get all of the information there. And you can also, there's an email address. You can email, I believe it's me. So you can email me with any of your questions. I love any and all questions. And of course, if you ever need anything, howardcc.edu is the place to go, where we have a calendar of events and everything that is going on is there. There's separate calendars for the Horowitz Center, of course, as they have their arts events. So everything is, we are really diligent about trying to make sure that the website is always up to date.
howardcc.edu is that website. My good friend, the little loop right there, the search bar, whatever you want to call it. She's my best friend. Everything that I need, I go there and I just search for that. Like I search, you know, if you're trying to find Grace, right? Maybe you're like, oh, wait a minute, I didn't see her email. Just go to howardcc.edu and just type Grace. Wait a minute, I didn't get that link again. Go to howardcc.edu, Fall for All. Like it's really a good tool. If you're looking to further your career, howardcc.edu, you know, just whatever you're interested in. Just there's a lot of information. And again, HCC has really opened its doors. HCC is really working towards making our campus friendly for all. And, you know, proof of that is the festival for Fall for All that we have coming up on October 20th. Grace, I want you to be the person to invite our community to come and join us on October 20th here at HCC.
Absolutely. I hope everybody comes and joins us October 20th, 11 to 2 on the Howard Community College Quad. We look forward to seeing you and we would hate to miss you. So please come by.
And do the dance rain, like, so no dance rain, I guess, is what it is, really. Sun dance, right. I don't know. What do we call it? We need to give it a name. Anything else, Grace, you want to say before we wrap our conversation up today?
No, thank you so much. This has been great. And I'm really excited about our inaugural Fall for All Festival. We hope to have this ongoing for years to come. And especially with HCPSS schools being closed, this was an amazing opportunity to offer our community.
And thank you to you and to everybody on the committee for really being thoughtful and inclusive and creating these great opportunities for all of our community to come and explore what HCC and our partners in our community have to offer to all, absolutely all. Like you said, from the youngest to the young at heart in our community, this is a festival where everybody should come. October 20th, 11 to 2 here at HCC. Until then, we are dancing for sun. We don't want any rain. So everybody do the dance. Thank you all for listening. Thank you all for watching. And until next time, I am Cris Oviedo.